So guys, today we are going to do something different. Today I will take you in my garden and we will enjoy the warm spring weather. Look at some plants that I'm going to schlep out here. My cats will also be happy that they can be in the video with me frolicking around. So we in Berlin, we have not yet total, you know, we are not, it's not that we are not allowed to go outside, but everyone says stay at home. So this is what we are going to do today. Stay at home, read some books, look at some plants, and first of all, use this fabulous spot here to make beautiful Instagrammable videos. See you in a second. So let's have a little garden tour. So this is from our landlords. This was the former stables. And this is where our landlord Klaus has all his gardening tools and all his, you know, flower and plant equipment. So I would say shed goals to that. So here's the rest of the garden. You see it's huge. It's partly under Nature Protection Act. I don't know how you say in English. And at the end, so behind those trees, there's a little river running down. So it's very romantic. And also in summer, full of mosquitoes. Yeah, and you can see here, so lots of spring flowers. Right now we have a blue phase, before that was a white phase. And then you see here, nice willow tree. And back there, that's still, you know, still not yet awakened. There will be ferns, lots of ferns. Will look like a prehistoric jungle in, I would say, two till three weeks. Yeah, and here is our house from the backside. So in the big house in the back is where our landlord and the landlady live. It's an old villa from beginning of last century. And then you see the newer block in front of it, this is where we live. So we don't live in the big villa, we live in the Anbau. I don't say, no, you know how to say in English. So in the extension of the house. And you see the big windows that we have and the trees in front of it. So it's very green and full of birds, songs and raccoon noises at night. So yeah, always something happening. Hi guys, so today I'm the reporter on site. I'm taking you with me in my garden that you already saw a little bit, and I try to find somewhat positive points in this whole corona epidemic situation. Here in Berlin it's still quite calm, everything is good so far, and we have of course the number of cases skyrocketed a bit, but that is to be expected. But I really, really feel for all of you that live in countries where the health system might not be so stable or also has higher barriers to get to. So for all of you in the US, I'm really, really praying that the wave is not hitting you with Walking Dead, you know, numbers and stuff like that. So, all right. In the meantime, I was thinking, what can I do? I need to stay at home. My Ronald is also at home. As I said, my cats enjoy this tremendously, but you know, you can only play with them that much. I already spent yesterday cleaning all the leaves of my plants. I found this very therapeutic and very calming. So they are all now clean. And I told you I'm going to show you my favorite trailing plants that I have at the moment, and this is what we are going to do today. So I just need to find a place to put my microphone. I hope I'm talking loud enough, because you know, you have the bird noises and the bicyclists that are going, you know, there, and then children, and yeah, okay, it is what it all what you need in an epidemic, and a white wine schorle or spritzer, some books I show you later. Yeah, so white wine schorle is this, it's the same German thing as like Apfelsaft schorle, or if you translate it, apple juice spritzer. And if you never had an Apfelsaft schorle, you're missing out. So how to make this is, you buy like apple juice, but you need to buy 100% apple juice, not something that is already like 70% and then sugar. So 100% apple juice, and then you fill the glass half full, and then the rest you put sparkling water in it, and it's fabulous. This is what all Germans drink all the time. If you want to have it a little bit fancy, you can also do this with rhubarb juice, and then you have a rhubarb spritzer or rhabarber schorle. This is all the craze here in summer in Germany. But for now, I think Apfelsaft schorle doesn't cut it today. I'm going for white wine spritzer. So cheers. All right, let's start with plants. The plant that is making me so happy right now is my Monstera Peru. You can every day see the growth, and she is also not being complicated. She is really using the pole I put in and curling herself around it. So I'm very, very happy about this plant right now. It only cost like €14.90, so €15 when I bought it back in October, I think. And look. Isn't it amazing? And those huge dragon scale leaves, so super cool. And you know, you see all the new growth, and this plant makes me so happy right now. Maybe also see what plant makes you happy, put it in your line of sight if you can, so every day you walk by it, you can, it can put a little smile on your face or something like that. So my next happy making trailing plant that I have right now, give me a second, I don't want to rip anything. Is my little silvery pothos. I don't know what of if N or whatever this specimen name is, I don't care. I bought it at Obi in September for like, I don't know, €3, had like 3 or 4 little leaves, didn't do nothing, and then 4 weeks ago it started to do something, and then I put it in a lighter spot, as a spot with more light, and since then those 2 long tendrils started to creep up on me, and you see those light blue. Yeah, need to check the white wine spritzer amount. Okay, those light green leaves, those are all, of course, new leaves, and I expect it to be end of summer a full-fledged plant. Right now still a teenager, so I think the growing up will go fast. Next we have Monstera Silticana, so a little bit more exotic. This plant I also got as a cutting for €14, €15 a couple of months back. It had like one or two leaves, and I put it in water, so you know, developed roots, and then I put it in soil, and this is what's happening. So every day also you see growth on this plant, lots of leaves, lots of growing happening, and I'm thinking, so in 2 weeks or so I need to put a bigger wooden stem in, so it's more secure on it, but for right now it makes me very happy. Look at it. Yeah. And then look at my macrame art project. This very, very nice philodendron micans. No, it's not a philodendron micans. Oh yes, it is. Maybe. Yeah, I don't know. Well, the velvety one. The velvety one. I don't know if it's Mikens or not. I can't be asked right now. So a log, velvety leaves, burgundy underside. I don't know if you can see in the sunlight. Let me see if I can. No, I can't adjust it. It's spring sun. I mean, at least we have sun. So it's trailing away. I put it on a pole so the leaves get bigger if they, when they grow upwards, but I'm thinking I will remove this and put it in a hanging basket so I can have the full trailing plant, you know, experience with this. I really, really love this. Look, it's very pretty. Lots of new leaves, and you know the new leaves are all small, so it means if I put, I'm going to put it in a spot where it has more direct light, so I hope that the leaves, you know, don't stay that small but get big and velvety and beautiful. So what else is there to do when a worldwide pandemic is happening? Read books. I know you all are going to watch a lot of YouTube content. Me too, but there comes a point that you can't watch anymore. I will put one of my channel tips at the end of this video. I don't know yet what I'm going to put there. Some of the less I don't know, expected and maybe guilty pleasure channels. Let's see what I come up with in editing. But so watching YouTube, watching Netflix, but then and listening to audiobooks, especially. I really, it's spring, so you're probably anyway in the mood of doing some deep spring cleaning. So, you know, getting all the cupboards and also like check your clothing racks and do all of this. And when you do this, I really highly recommend listening to podcasts or to audiobooks. Of course, Joe Rogan comes to mind, and for podcasts, and also maybe see if there is a podcast about your favorite TV show. So for me, it's The Walking Dead that I listen to every week, to the recap, and also Westworld started. So, and I must say, the first episode of Westworld, did you watch it? What the hell? It was, I mean, I didn't understand a thing, and I hate TV shows where, you know, need to watch till episode 5 to, you know, even understand what's, you know, as a way of building. Okay, so you watched all of, or what you can watch, you listen to, or what you can listen to. What else is there to do? Read books. So today I'm not going to bore you with some popular science or complicated stuff. Today we are, I'm going to share with you my fantasy novel highlights. Yes, and I like books that are as thick as they can be. So. Fortunately, because I like to read, I read fast, so I read all the books that are out there. You know, I had already read all the books I thought, but luckily I found a couple of new authors in the last 2 years that I really, really can highly recommend. So let's start. Also, the series they put out to the market are already finished, so you can, you know, you don't have to wait 5 years for something to happen. So the first book I'm going to show you is from Pierce Brown, and it's called Red Rising. And now my neighbor wants to cross the path, so give me a second. Okay, neighbor passed with his wheelbarrow. So anyway, Pierce Brown, Red Rising. There are, so this series has 4 books. There's one more to come, I believe, but the first 3 are, you know, are in itself complete. I can really, really highly recommend if you like fantasy. It's not so much fantasy. It's also a little bit. It's young adult, but it has not this like plot that you have already read 700 million times. So I would recommend go on Amazon, read the synopsis and see if this is would be interesting for you. I can say this book has lots of twists and turns and interesting character development, that it's not like black and white. There's a lot of gray and looking at it from different perspectives, you know, on the same situation. And I really, really enjoyed those books tremendously. They play on, don't be afraid, it plays on Mars, but it's not like sci-fi blah. It also has a cool school, so if you like Harry Potter stuff, so this could be something for you. A little bit Harry Potter, Hunger Gamey stuff, you know, so very cool. All right, the next book I'm going to show you, I saw this book for years and years, and I said, a book that has a cover that looks like this, I can't even. The cover art is so cheap on all the Brandon Sanderson books, at least the first editions, because it's all this like little Tor Fantasy publishing house, and this is not working for me, because when a cover looks like this, it looks like a, you know, €1 page turner, like a, I don't know how to say it in English, but in German you say I don't even know what to say. But there is a word in German to describe those like cheap little books. But this book is not at all cheap or little. It's the first part of the Mistborn series. It has three books, and then there are more books later, whatever. So if you ever have heard of Brandon Sanderson, I don't even need to tell you anything, because you know everything about that. If you have never heard of Brandon Sanderson, are interested in a little bit of magic and a little bit of a heist story and cool world building and action and adventure, this is the book for you. Go and check it out. Ah, I brought, this is the first edition. Look at this cover. And then they republished it again. And this is the new cover of this is the book three. But you see the difference. You see the difference a cover can make. So it's the same, you know, series, same author, different publishing house. There you go. So this looks much more appealing to a market, you know, in my opinion. All right, and the last book I'm going to show you today is one I'm reading right now. This is the second book of a three-part series, and you see how thick it is? And it's an English that thick, so for all you German people watching it, you can imagine if a book is that thick in English, how big it would be in German. So, totally my cup of tea. It's James Islington, it's an Australian author. It's very high fantasy, epic fantasy, with thousands and thousands of years of history and backstory and whatnot, and multiple main characters that all have different goals. And this is book two, and we still not sure exactly who the person or the entity is we fighting against. They also don't know, because they lost their memories and, you know, their magic swords and stuff like that. So it's a perfect thing to do when you need to, you know, have to stay at home for the next 4 weeks to go get into something like this. This also works as an audiobook, so, you know, to help you clean your house and stuff like that. So yeah, this was my tip for the beginning of the end of the world. So first of all, calm down by cleaning your plants. Second, calm down by deep cleaning all of your house and your cupboards and whatnot. Listen to podcasts while you do it, and then after you have watched all the YouTube and the Netflix of the world, start reading a book. All right, I thank you for your attention. I'm going to have a Schorle and Saba. If you can get my picture, Saba is all right, you know, needs to talk to you about her, the hardness of her life. Sweetheart, what's your hardship today? I don't know. All right, so cheers. I'm saying goodbye from Berlin, Germany to you. Take care, stay safe.
Petro, komm mal her. Komm mal her. Komm mal her, mein Schatz.
Do you want to be in the video? Okay, Pedro is a bit shy. Shy cat.
B-roll with cats, because of course they showed up when I stopped filming. This is normal cat politics. You are drama cat, Pedro. It's the big tiger. The big tiger and the stick.
Hey there, I see a ball.